Hello. Okay, this is part two. Make sure we're going live. We are. Hooray! Yeah, so this is part two. Give you a little close up zoom of the eye of Annie Mac. And if we zoom back out, you'll see that this is where we left off. Annie Mac. A little bit more to do on it. So, yeah, we'll carry on. Hopefully that's okay for you in the screen there. Let time difference catch up just so I can see it on YouTube. Make sure you can see it all okay. Gonna do a little bit in the background and tweak the face a little bit, and then I'm gonna call this one done. There's a couple of areas that I've kind of noticed as I came back into the room, things I have to kind of shift around and play around with. I'm just gonna get stuck in and get this finished. One of the first things I noticed was this arm, that there's a more of a curve coming out of the top here, so I'm just going to pull some of this paint across and over just to map out where this arm is, so you can hear the household in the background. And yes, if you were watching earlier on, we finished our Sunday lunch, it was lovely. Just gives a bit more volume to that shoulder space. It'll help kind of mapping the edge of where that table is as well. A bit heavy on that side. Cross over, come all round there, and straight down from that point. A little softer, fluffier edges, but I'm going to play around with the background anyway, so I'll be able to fill up and push the edges on that. Yeah, that's where we're at. I'll click the screen up so I can see it properly. Oh yeah, all you could see was my microphone. Awesome. I'll zoom out a little bit further, maybe. Okay, I'll move the screen across so you don't get the lovely shot on the side of my head. So yeah, I hope your Sunday's going okay. I'm actually going to change the zest it over as well in the little pan, because it's starting to get quite mucky in there. It's a bit like changing water. When you're doing watercolours, you know, once the water gets dirty, there's no point putting dirty water onto your picture, there's no point putting inky solvents into your painting. I forgot about that. You've been able to see that. I'm going to move this microphone down close to my mouth because where I've been painting, perfect position of the mic. I've allowed a great deal of time lapse. It's like a secret painting being hidden by the microphone cable. sound of our cats attacking each other. The old drop and stuff on the floor. This little backdrop sound to the painting. Just lighten the inside of that eye up a little bit. Brush off. Especially when you paint with light. Accidentally pour in a different colour, it really starts to show through. What I do is kind of blend some of these paint marks in. I just want to give a hint of a shadow on that side. I think I need to pull this one out a little bit more. It's really subtle, really subtle. Just want to give space to that nose so it doesn't look too sort of measly and thin. So I'm just kind of softening some of these marks and maybe not a little bit too strong. Don't even hear it in the background. Obviously not happy about something. This helps frame that eye a little bit better, I think. Drawing individual eyebrows and drawing kind of the shadow shapes of them. There's a really like delicate shadow around that chin. So I'm trying to place that in a little bit better. I'll give myself a bit of a break on the small detail and go straight into this background a little bit, because it's starting to get a little bit fluffy. And get some more structure back in there, I think. And go for a mid-size struggle brush that I had earlier on. This is the one. Looking if I still have paint then from earlier. Load it up really well over this little lighter area. It's quite white in that corner. Put the whole white to it. Like that further. We'll go back up the top and darken that whole area in, but I wanted to give a good indication of where that corner was. Let's bring this back out. This colour comes all the way over to fill in. Gaps around the hair. Trying to reduce that kind of, I didn't want a halo effect going in there. So this is quite a nice, lovely flat colour right beside the head. There's a bit of a shadow there that comes from this light picture, so I'm going to leave that little bit in there just to give myself an indication of where that is. I think it's lighter again, just underneath this bit here. better. Toss whether to put this light fixture and jug. Yeah, I'm still not too sure that it's gonna work or not, but there's something I like about it, but got a light thing going through there. Trying to map that out. Seems we've got a kind of shadow starting to appear. It's a bit of a shame not to put it in. A lot of glare. The light on the paints is really hard to see. Canvas sometimes. Sorry for a block of view. So I think this eyebrow needs to come over. A wee tad, I'm just looking at that. I think it needs to come over just a wee tad to about there. So, think at stage you shouldn't be really afraid of changing structures. If the nose is wrong, because the eye is wrong, all these things are going to have a knock-on effect with each other, and there's a bit of a shadow which comes around this way. Just to give a wee hint to this side of the nose, where it's a bit strong, and take that back a bit. There's always lots of screaming going on in the background. Everybody is okay, it's just that everybody's used to overreacting to things. when he was mentioning Max's very expressive eyebrows during the portrait session this morning. I think they're beautifully kept. Which the sculpture just really helps paint, because you get to see where structures are and it helps you map things from them. Of an error there. That was to the best of us. Concentrating on what I was doing, I just put a bloody mark on her nose. Let's see if we can lift that off. Better. Kind of led me away from what I was concentrating on, which was this little jug and lamp thing going on. Still don't know whether to put it in or not, but it's. Do put it in. What do you think? Strange when you're doing a portrait of something. Suddenly, some object in the background becomes one of those things that I think shouldn't be given that much consideration, but I planned to put it there initially, but I just don't know whether it's worthy of being there or not. Then. Well, I think the thing is, let's stick it there. There's a little tiny sketch. No, don't like it. Let him take it out. Sometimes objects in portraiture have meaning, actually mean something to a person. That's why they're in there. I'm not too sure whether this jigger does or not. It could be just purely decorational, but I think I'm going to put it in here anyway. Let's get the location of that, and then a little tiny. Jug thing that looks like a candle or some sort. It's a little tiny still life with the is anything else going on as well? Just let me know that this line is way off and it should be up here somewhere as well. I'll go sketching these. It's very loosely sketching where these go. Excuse me. But with a new table lens. Then we've got the plug pot, which is about the round bits. Roughly where the lamp is. Hopefully you can still see okay. Try and move these out a little bit. So make a slightly skewed angle from that. Again, it is looking very sort of yellowy underneath these lights, even though it's kind of a very bright daylight bulb shining on it. A bit of reflection in the table surface as well. I'm just mapping shapes here. I'm not worried about too much about colour correctness just yet. Obviously I'm using sort of greenish colour. I don't want to use bright pink for a green plant. The plant is virtually kind of black in areas as well, just green greenness to it in places. You might think, well, why would you bother spending so much time drawing this plant? I think it's the scale involved. Which gives a sense of distance, which can support the portrait. Knowing that a thing looks a certain way. Help kind of give you a sense of contrast and control over scales and things like that. So having an idea that it's kind of a plant, I'm so perfect in these. It's kind of like a plant and how the leaves work, and a little tank plant pot. Let's look at all. Okay, so I'm going to kind of dab in some of these little marks. You know, for example, if I didn't get this, the perspective right on the curve of the bowl and the pot, it would throw you out for other things, like what is this to sat on, not understanding it's a table. You know, how far away is it from the wall, because it's a certain sense of depth. It's more of a purpley colour, isn't it? In there. Ooh, it's very blue. Pop this in just for a guesstimate. It's way too dark. That's too dark, but it's a lot better. Maybe color in the background. Saying before about this little shadow. And the table. Thank you. There we go, lovely singing of Andrew and Cal in the background. As we can kind of see all the different colours starting to come through in shadows and things as well. Kind of fun painting the background. Nothing against any Mac, but let me just flip this door shut. Sorry, guys. Sometimes I forget. Shouldn't forget that I was doing this, and I don't want the wrong. Seeing broadcast on the internet, maybe they do, I don't know. Should we do an attempt to let me? Oh, no way! I was going to put it on as a Facebook alert message, Ethan, but I thought I didn't want to bombard people with me all day. So I just thought I'd let Facebook do its thing. Obviously, it didn't. Cheers, Facebook. Did you hear a Carl and Andrew sing in the background? Lovely tune of Roxanne. Want to be bombarded. There's always that etiquette, isn't there? There's that worry that if you post too much of on Facebook or YouTube, people get annoyed with you. Switch off. Maybe they do that anyway. And clean these brushes off. With a little break from that, I'm pleased where I've mapped everything in. Can't believe to put those background bits in as well. I wasn't too sure to begin with. I'm kind of happy now where they are. You can obviously see that it's my picture's a lot more cropped in than the photo reference. I don't mind that too much because they were the part of the inside of that table which kind of got a lot of it lost. But I do like the idea that this kind of leads you into the back to anyway, kind of pushes her off the background a little bit. Still need to figure out this nose a little bit. This is still not quite resolved. That's just a little reminder to get that done. A wee break, I think. You can hear it a little bit. Yeah, but how else are people going to know when you stream? This is very true. But this is more for me. It's more for the continuation of the time lapse I'm going to do. So I think people kind of saw the gist of what I was painting today for the 5 hours. So it turns out your extension cord cable was a bit loose and I kicked my boot, which nudged it, causing the entire PC to turn off. Perfect. So I've got a cat that does that. Inky's got this amazing talent of just standing on the right button. which is awesome. It's funny how that skewed the picture. Let's see if we can get you. No, I won't bother. I was going to try and move the camera around and get you a better straight on picture, but I think it'll probably mess up the time lapse as well. So, it's just me and you having a chat, Ethan. That's cool, isn't it? So we've been doing this for 89 minutes. Got us painting there. We're going to do 4 hours. Technical kitty. Yeah. An hour and 30 over the 4 hours. It's okay, I don't mind. I'm not going to crucify myself because I didn't do it in 4 hours. This is the first time I've painted since probably the last sky portrait Sunday painting thing. I only painted a couple of times in that. I love painting. It's almost like a treat I never allow myself. I love drawing, but the painting side of it. I can lose myself in painting, lose myself in drawing, but painting is one of those things you kind of, it's quite combative, where I think my safe zone is with drawing. And I don't want it to be a safe zone and a trap to stop me from painting. So I've got to kind of challenge myself now and again. And this is the ideal kind of format for it, you know, the sky portrait kind of pushing you out there to literally paint. I'll look at her face a little bit and just see where I'm at with it. I think I'm okay. Getting there. Keep seeing little bits I can kind of. As I have my break, multitasking, breaking and painting at the same time, probably a bad idea. Hope you didn't lose any of your work, Ethan, when your computer switched off by accident. Soften those eyelashes a little bit and bring this down. really the painterly quality in this. I'm not sort of trying to go for a sort of a photorealism. Yeah, stopped working a little while ago. Did a lot of car work, had a week off, so I can fix anything up. I forgot all this. Cool. Getting ahead of the game, it's good stuff. Noticing something there on the tabletop, just how this shadow kind of washes out about there. A little hint of it here. Like the shadow on the tabletop for that candle, sensing those little. Part of this face of the light. I'm also aware that I haven't painted this bit in yet. Nice globe. Put some of this pinkish what do you call that? increase the size of that pupil on the left hand side as well. Thank you. Now I'm starting to fiddle now a little bit with this. I've got a little bit more to do in that background. I want to try and get this hair sorted out a little bit as well. I'm getting used to the kind of rhythm of the flow of the hair, so I'm going to kind of ghost the direction of the hair, and there's a lovely curl. Which kind of flows around like that. Make sure there's plenty of paint so we get a nice flow to it. Thank you. Come along nicely. Thank you very much, Cal. Hey, Cal. Ethan. Just lucky I didn't call you Winky. Oh dear. Always when you start to get tired, you make stupid mistakes like I just done. Okay, I think that's enough. I think we'll call it with that and leave it there. I might have a look at it tomorrow morning, fresh pair of eyes, and see where I'm going with it. But that's it. Alright, thanks for being with us. Ethan, always a pleasure to see you, son. Hope we get to see each other really soon in real life rather than COVID world. But take care of yourself, son. Give us a shout whenever you need. And send us your Christmas list. Alright, chat soon. Take care. Bye bye.